Good evening. Today I am doing a presentation on compiler design gate. Some questions on compiler design gate. This presentation is done by three members: Aurithra Sinha, roll number 120, Arijit De, roll number 121, and Akash Banerjee, roll 140. Today is 3rd of December and it is approximately 8:30 p.m. So this is the first question, which appeared in GATE 2001, and which we have to identify which of the following statements is false. Of these, the four statements are here as follows, and the right answer is A. An unambiguous grammar has seam leftmost and rightmost deviation. Next, the explanation is: if a grammar has more than one leftmost or rightmost derivation for a single sentential form, the grammar is ambiguous. The leftmost and the rightmost derivations for a sentential form may differ even in an unambiguous grammar. So this was the answer. And for the next question, I would request Akash Banerjee to continue.
Thank you. So the given question which we have is, we have an expression grammar E and F, and we need to know which one of the following is true. This is a GATE CS 2000 question, and our options are: star has higher precedence than plus, minus with respect to star, plus and minus have same precedence, and plus has higher precedence than star. So I say the answer is option A, and the explanation is because, you know, precedence in respect is often enforced by making sure that the production rule which we have, there is, you know, higher precedence operator will never produce an expression with lower precedence. That means that if an operator has a higher precedence, that will come first, that will be operated first with respect to having a lower precedence operator. Now if we go back to the question, we see that our option A is that star has a higher precedence than plus. We know that when the when we come across operators, we know that with record as respect to precedence, star is operated before plus, and henceforth that is our answer. The next question will be explained by Arijit De. Arijit, if you can please explain it.
Good evening, sir. I am Arijit De. And question number 3 is, which of the following suffices to convert an arbitrary CH to an LL1 grammar? Okay, so there is three options: removing left recursion alone, factoring the grammar alone, removing left recursion and curing the grammar, and the option is none of the above, because these options are not sufficient. We need little extra to convert than the MCQ options are given.
Okay, so those were, okay, so